Good morning and thank you for joining us on Press of the Press this morning on Plus TV Africa. I am Benny Ark, and joining me this morning on Of the Press is Femi Idowu-Adegoke. Good morning, Femi.
Good morning.
And thank you for joining us this morning.
You're welcome.
Let's go into the headlines this morning from our national dailies. We start off with the Punch newspaper. Oil price sink to $24 per barrel, lowest in 17 years. And NNPC reduces petrol pump price to 125 naira per litre. The FARC meeting ends in deadlock over revenue remittances. FG slashes budget by 1.5 trillion naira, reduces benchmark to $30. And still in the punch, mother, baby, three others test positive as cases rise to 8. American contact of AKT case dies, Nigerian companion tests negative. Government faces tough tax, traces 800 contacts, and Northwest Kwara closed schools. Lagos Ogun ban gathering of over 50 people as the Lagos State government schools shut down. NYSC suspends orientation to discharge core members. And still in the punch this morning, Rev. Summons and MFLM ex-minister bosses over 8 years on audited account. JAM releases another 450,000 UTME results. PDP welcomes back Oyinlola, Obada, Arakpaja, and others. Lagos explosion, residents condemn FHA boss takeover comment. And CBN announces 1.1 trillion naira intervention fund to boost economy. And there's a new confirmed case in Ekiti, an American and two Nigerians, a driver, and also the caregiver. Interestingly, the American passed on, as was confirmed this morning by the Commissioner for Health of Ekiti. During the news, the driver is still under observation, and the caregiver is negative still and still under observation. What are your thoughts on all of this?
Well, we are sympathized with who's lost his life and people who have tested positive for coronavirus. But the challenge is still our approach to this pandemic, yeah, as described by the World Health Organization. We had time to put things in place. We had time to mitigate it. But maybe reality is done on us now that we're not immune to having it. Now, in one day, just in one day, we have 5 cases on our hand. And for almost a month, we had only 3. So it should tell us how rapid and how fast this COVID-19 can actually spread.
Yes.
And in one of the headlines, it says 800, they are tracing 800 contacts.
Yes.
That's huge. And those 800, you don't know where they've been to.
Yes.
And that's why we shouldn't have pussyfooted on closing our borders and having travel bans. And then, like, for example, in Zimbabwe, they don't even have any case yet. But their president has come out speaking. I don't want to go into that argument about Nigerians saying our president has not spoken. Some are for it and some are for against it. But the challenge is Nigeria is on a, what I call a free fall when it comes to leadership.
Yes.
The people, I'm calling on Nigerians now to take, I've always said it, we need to take our own life and our destiny in our hands.
Yeah, I think another interesting thing that happened in the course of all of this yesterday, the shutting down of orientation camp, because the people in NYC orientation camp, they've asked everybody to vacate camp and go back home. Good preventive and precautionary measure right there.
Yeah.
But I'm still perturbed about the fact that we still allow our airports open for zones, the countries who have been tagged as high-risk zones, we still have people coming into the country from this country. And I'm wondering why the government isn't totally putting a restriction, a complete ban on those high-risk countries.
No, I think they've done that. I think they've done that now, and it's only if you're Nigerians who can come. If you're Nigerian, you can return home. You know, you're allowed back. But non-Nigerians from those, I think 13 countries have been listed now. And Nigeria police.
The American who came in Ekiti with his driver and the caregiver.
They came in before the ban. That's what I was saying. They came in before the ban. We pussyfooted too much. We delayed so many things. And some people will argue that it's for economic reasons. Some people will argue for different reasons. But what I'm saying is, when you're aligned.
I think at this point, the public health of all Nigerians should matter beyond any economic reason.
Exactly. It's not when you're alive that you have economic purpose. Yes. When you're gone, there's no economic purpose. So, but we should commend the health sectors in this country as the Minister of Health, and especially Lagos State, because I think it's about Lagos State, only Lagos State, that seems to be ready. Because I was reading in one of the papers, even in Abuja, the hospital has only 12 beds. So
let's go to the next dailies with us this morning. And from that, we check the Nation newspaper this morning. The first headline, Senate panel okays military police rejig and debate to continue. Oil marketers orders back petrol price court. It's now 125 a liter. Two doctors, 159 others die of Lassa fever. And JAM releases 450,000 UTME resorts. Churches, mosques, schools shut in COVID-19 lockdown. And Lagos, Ogun ban gatherings of more than 50. Lagos, Kwara, Northwest states send pupils home. And flights from US, UK, Italy orders ban. American suspected virus carrier dies in Ekiti. And government freezes employment as 2020 budget is cut by 1.5 trillion naira. Ex-Rivers Governor Odili under probe for 100 billion naira fraud. Oil marketers orders back petrol price court. It's now 125 naira per litre. What's your reaction to this?
Well, I think the government and the National Petroleum Corporation, NNPC, I think they've done the fair on them. They've done what is right because the price is dropped. And then there's so much going on economically.
It's now below $30.
Yeah, yeah. And then I think it was yesterday that the Minister of Finance actually announced that they've shifted the benchmark for the budget to $30 per barrel.
Yes.
But now it's even gone lower than
$30.
So we are already, even the shifting, we're on deficit.
And maybe we'll argue the fact that the fuel price pump is still too high relative to the fact that crude is as low as it is right now.
But don't forget that the budget has to be funded from somewhere. So, but it's good that they've reduced it. It's good for the people to have a kind of soccer form.
All right. Now, this was a long time coming. Finally, churches, mosques, schools shut in COVID-19 lockdown. I'm just hoping if this is going to be across the nation. Lagos seem to be taking the forefront in all of this, shutting down schools and gatherings of more than 50 people.
Yeah. You know. Yeah, Lagos has always taken the lead anyway. And then Nigeria presently, with the COVID-19, I think even the federal government is relying more on Lagos. Mm. So I think with what Lagos has done, is one of the papers that Ekiti, what's it called? Osun and Ekiti are considering closing schools and then putting bans on
In my opinion, I think all schools should be shut down at this point in time.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying.
There's no need compromising
We don't have to wait until it gets bad. We can put preventive measures.
Pupils don't have to start getting infected and dying before
A 6-month-old baby is caught it, and then we are...
Now, this is a very interesting one. Two doctors, 159 others die of Lassa fever. And one would have think, COVID-19 is taking the center page. And Lassa fever, people are still dying of Lassa fever.
Yeah.
What are we not paying attention to here?
That's our own local epidemic.
Yes.
Because one of the major causes of Lassa fever is public health. When we have deaths on our streets, we don't have proper waste management system, we don't have proper waste collection, we don't have proper drainage cleaning system. So it's on both the government and the people, self-hygiene. COVID-19 is taking the center stage because it's an unknown virus that just come.
Yes.
But Lassa fever has been killing Nigerians in the past 4 or 5 years.
Even when COVID is doing right now.
Because I think its own incubation period is so short and you're gone. Because with COVID-19, it has to be in the body for, 14 days before it begins to manifest. But with Lassa fever, it's just...
Now, interesting, we did have a health expert on the news earlier on, and he was talking about social distancing, which is what the World Health Organization has prescribed as one of the measures to curtailing the spread of the virus. And he said in a country like ours, that might be very hard to achieve, you know. And then I'm just wondering, what could the government do more as precautionary preventive measures from this virus spreading if social distancing will be difficult?
Yeah. You know? We've talked about what... the government should have done and what they can do in the course of our discussion now. like the churches and the mosques.
Yes.
All these things should have, the airport ban, testing. I'm not even sure we have testing kits across the country, but I know they are testing in Lagos. Mm. But the testing kit should be available at point of entry. It shouldn't just be at, we need to.
So at this point, the best preventive precautionary measure we have is just washing of your hands.
Yeah, everybody. Well, I think everybody is aware of that. Lagos State has been doing jingles about that on the radio, on the TV, even videos. They've been sending that around because I've seen a couple of them. So I think those are the way, but we need to be more proactive in our doings, not wait until we have big issue in our hand. Now, the federal government and everybody is running because it was being debated on the floor of the National Assembly yesterday, because now we are having from 3, we've gone to 8 in one day.
Yes.
And those, we have about 800 people to be tracked.
Yes.
So imagine those 800, it's going to be highly exponential if 800 people get into the
and those
space.
People get in contact with,
yeah, with different
other
people.
Different people.
Before you know it, it's rapid spreading. So I think closing down churches, mosques, worship places, even anywhere, even burials, even any gathering of more than, for me, they're saying 50. For me, anywhere that is gathering more than 25 people, you should, because the countries of this world has all the where to do. They treated it with levity because Italy just accepted that they didn't take it serious, but they're paying dearly for it.
You know, and not even contribute to any panic or fear that is already going around because of the COVID-19. I'm even thinking our eateries, our restaurants, places we go get food from. I mean, you can't necessarily verify. Already we have problem not knowing how much of hygiene is maintained behind closed doors where this food come from.
Yeah.
Do you think the government also should be looking into the restaurants, I mean?
Well, for economic reasons, yes, the government might not do that. But as people, I think we should stay in our houses and
cook your food and eat in your
house.
Yes,
and have minimum contact.
Let's take a look at the Vanguard this morning. In the Vanguard, coronavirus, Lagos Ogun going into lockdown. Both states banned gathering above 50 persons in churches, mosques. Mm-hmm. As federal government bans travel from 14 countries, suspend visas. NYC shut orientation camp, says no core member official infected. 5 new cases, including 6-week-old baby, confirmed. Total case, now 8. Address Nigerians on effort to combat coronavirus. Senate urges Buhari. Federal government cuts 2020 budget by 1.5 trillion naira. An American dies of coronavirus in Ekiti. Driver positive on the watch. And oil price down to $28 as federal government drops petrol price to 125 naira per liter. Woman who tested negative to COVID-19 in Enugu dies. UTME, we're having cancelled resorts, says Jam. An APT crisis, horse trading that saved Oshiomale. And both states ban gatherings above 50 persons in churches and mosques, and that's Lagos State and Ogun State. I mean, shouldn't this be adopted nationwide?
Yeah, I think it should. It should be nationwide. No one should wait until it gets to your doorstep. And another thing I'll put in there is that we shouldn't just wait as people. We shouldn't wait for government. If you notice in your area as community people, community leaders, and you notice that any religious houses are flouting this order, you should report to the government.
Interestingly,
we should take our own destiny in our own hands.
The Senate is urging Buhari to address Nigerians in the effort to combat coronavirus. And I'm wondering, I watched the nationwide address of South African President Cyril Ramaphosa, and also that of another African that of Ghana also. Yeah. And I'm just wondering why till now we've not heard a single word from our president, which many people say is typical of him. I mean, this is of global concern. And so we should have gotten some national address from the president. I mean, let me just pick your brains on this.
Do you want my honest opinion?
Your honest opinion, yes.
I'm really not surprised, and I'm not for or against it. You understand, I'm much neutral about it. Because President Buhari over time has shown that things that are not directly or benefit or affecting him and the presidency, he rarely talks about them. We've seen the case of Benue, when people were killed, died in Benue State. We've seen several cases. We've seen just recently now in Lagos State, the bomb blast and this COVID-19. It's rather shameful that it takes the floor of the National Assembly to be talking debating.
Because we're hearing more from the Minister of Health, from the Minister of Health for State. All of these people can actually give the president briefing and let him come out and give the nation address based on the briefing he has been getting so far. Well, because I don't want to believe he has not been briefed by all of these people.
He has been briefed. But the challenge is his person.
It's not so much of a tax to achieve, isn't it?
It's his person and belief. If you're formed in your own way, that's why I'm not holding it against him. It's Nigerians who decide that this is the kind of leadership we want, and we've gotten it. But you mentioned the ministers. They're doing their job, the job they're being paid for. Yes, I always commend the Minister of Health, Federal Minister of Health, because they go on a daily basis giving information about COVID-19. But for me, the political class, even the Senate that are now calling out, it's a shame. He has to take the Senate. Now, if Buhari comes out tomorrow to speak, it's lost its value. Because he's supposed to be, he's not going to come out and tell us how to combat COVID-19. Correct. But he's supposed to give the people a leadership and a belief.
Updates.
Yes.
Measures that have been put in place. A sort of comfort
that, oh, our leaders are with us. The man we voted for is actually taking the lead on this. We know the ministers are doing their bit and the health workers are doing their bit. But even it's 2 minutes statement that, look, Nigerians, this is where we are, this is what we're doing. Let's just all come, just a word. Some people are just waiting for that to believe, because a lot of Nigerians believe we are immune to COVID-19 and it's not happening. Oh, well. And some people, until when the president or someone speaks.
I think that is a myth that has been demystified now. Yes, we are not immune to COVID-19. Yeah. And we take a look at this day this morning. CBN to scale up economic support with extra 1.1 trillion naira. Health sector gets fresh 100 billion naira incentive and sets up 1.5 trillion naira infrastructure fund implementation committee. Taraba governor's prolonged absence from state provokes fresh controversy. And FG to cut 2020 budget by 1.5 trillion naira deregulates petrol pricing. NNPC reduces pump price to 125 naira. At last, federal government restricts travel from US, UK, France, 10 others. Records 5 new COVID-19 cases, shuts NYC camps nationwide. Lagos suspends gatherings above 50 persons, joins Northwest governors to close schools. And NAF, 17 terrorists, bandits killed in Kaduna. And that's all we have in this day this morning. At last, the federal government restricts travel from US, UK, France, and 10 others. Many people have said, a little too late, because we've had cases coming to the country undetected.
Yeah,
and
already.
After a few days, I mean, they submit themselves, surrender themselves.
Yeah.
It's still better this is done now.
Yeah.
So we're hoping in some way this could be some precautionary preventive measure to further spread. But for those already with us here, the 800 unaccounted cases, it calls for bother.
It's a big concern, but we don't want to send panic down the line. But the truth is that let's just take caution individually. And if you feel you are having fever or you're feeling funny.
Femi, when you say that it's pretty funny. You know, the symptoms of COVID-19 is not so different from that of Lassa fever.
Yeah, that's why they share
similar symptoms in some type of way.
That's why they say go on to self-isolation.
Yes.
When you self-isolate yourself, then you know which one it is, if it is malaria, or if it is Lassa fever, or if it is COVID-19. So the advice is, let's take all the precautionary measures, wash your hands with water and soap, and if there's no water and soap, get a sanitizer.
Avoid secluded places with certain distance from people.
So we should do much as we can, as in personally, to get this. It's a huge and a big situation for the entire globe.
It's a global pandemic.
Yeah, for the entire globe.
Yes.
It's not something to joke with. I've had calls from people all over the world saying different things. I follow the news and I see, that's the painful thing. When you see global leaders all over the world coming out to speak, and people are giving excuse for our president not even talking to the people. Even just take the information, like you said.
I don't think there's any excuse to be given for docility.
Yeah. Because in Zimbabwe, I read that this morning, they don't even have any case in Zimbabwe, but their president is out speaking and putting bans in places on a travel bans.
Yes.
And they already, that's not saying they're not going to have it, but at least they're already ahead of having their first case.
Yes.
We waited till he get to hate before we started.
Femi Idowu-Adegoke, thank you very much for joining us on Off the Press this morning.
It's a pleasure.
And thank you for staying with us. Off the Press out this morning. We'll be back same time tomorrow. Do join us. This is Plus TV Africa, and I am Benny Ark. Good morning.